I so need to hear that passage of scripture again and again and again in my life. Because I'm a natural born worrier. I don't know about you. I can just worry when there's absolutely no need to worry. Ask for nothing. Pray about everything. Learn to work together. Keep your brain fixed on the beautiful, the good, the true, the noble, the pure. I so need that. I'm revisiting, Nancy and Walter and I are revisiting a series of talks that I first did in the summer of the 2012 session called Create Dangerously. And Create Dangerously is a title of Albert Camus' last lecture given in the 1950s in Uppsala, Sweden. And I think that it has much to say to creatives, to artists, and I think it has much to say to worship leaders and servants of the body of Christ. But before launching into Create Dangerously, which I will do tomorrow, I want to sort of segue from Jim's remarks in the presidential address yesterday, which I did not get to hear, but he was kind enough to share his content with me. And I'm focusing on the beautiful. And I think so many of us are evangelicals or charismatics. We've grown up with such an emphasis of truth. We're so worried about getting the truth part right that sometimes we can let the good and goodness and beauty fall by the wayside. But those of us who've grown up mainstream Protestant perhaps really cling to goodness, wanting to get the goodness part right, and sometimes leaving beauty and truth to kind of scatter to the sides. But coming to the beautiful, that is something that is so redemptive and so energizing to me. I was 8 years old in 1957 when the John Ford film The Searchers with John Wayne hit the big screen. My parents took me with them to see that. It was probably my first exposure to racial prejudice as an 8-year-old child. Of course, it was the Anglos prejudiced against the Native Americans, in this case, the Comanche tribe. And in that film, you see love overcome hate, overcome prejudice. And I was probably too young to really get that message, but I could feel it. And it was set in the beautiful context of Monument Valley. How many know what Monument Valley looks like? So gorgeous. This just a few months ago, my bride Janet and I drove west, and I got to see Monument Valley. And I remember at 8 years old, I didn't know to call it Monument Valley, but seeing those incredible rock formations coming up out of the ground, where John Wayne was striding around, being the big shot, that'll be the day, you know, and then finding a way to overcome his prejudice against the Comanche tribe to embrace and redeem his niece out of captivity. And all of that beauty made an enormous impact on that old 8-year-old boy that I was. And to reconnect those dots now, 60 years later, was an amazing victory. Clint Eastwood had the good, the bad, and the ugly. He ain't got nothing on us. We've got the beautiful, the good, and the true. The beautiful, the good, and the true. The problem is that everything within us and without us, the world, the flesh, and the devil, the lust of our eyes, the lust of our flesh, and the pride of life, are militating against the beautiful, the good, and the true, doing everything they can to wreck all that is beautiful, good, and true, to keep our minds off the beautiful and the good and the true. Exactly the opposite of what the apostle was encouraging us to do, to stay our minds, fix our anchor, set our sails in the beautiful, the good, and the true. In the 1980s, I was spending a lot of time as I have for decades, reading arts critique, and I was just first getting into the visual arts and going to galleries and exhibits and museums and had a little money to travel really for the first time. And I remember the whole art world being scandalized in 1987 by a work by an artist named Andres Serrano. The work was called Piss Christ. If you're offended by the title, that's what he intended. Piss Christ. It was a photograph of a crucifix that had been immersed in a tank of the artist's urine. And it was even supported by the National Endowment for the Arts, which caused quite a scandal. But literally everything in life is set up, all that has fallen without us and within us is set up to wreck the beautiful, the good, and the true. What Serrano didn't get is that someone who knew Jesus could look at that and not be so scandalized and realize that that is exactly what Jesus did. He immersed himself in the yuck that we are in order to lift us out of it. But we live in an era when our most trusted agencies come to goodness now. When our most trusted agency, relief agencies, scandalously misappropriated funds and misbehaved in areas where people are desperately needing help. Money gets misspent. People at the top abusively take all the money, and it's not spent on the people who need it so desperately. Look at how truth is manipulated. Televangelists, churches, denominations, different ones, individuals, we manipulate truth to our own advantage, to our own ends, to further our own arguments. There is much that we can do to promote the focus on the beautiful, the good, and the true. And not all of it takes a whole lot of energy. We've been worshiping recently at Christ Church Cathedral, the Episcopal Cathedral in downtown Nashville. And I have yet to meet the dean, Timothy Kimbrough. We've exchanged a few emails and we plan to get together for coffee later this month. But as I was walking out of worship one Sunday, I walked past him near the exit, and Dean Timothy said, "Go well, brother." You know that phrase, "Go well, brother." He said it with vigor and intentionality. Now, I don't know him well enough to know if he has spent a lot of time studying the Itay and Misa Est. Go ye therefore, it's ended, the dismissal of the Mass. But that's the effect that it had on me. Itay, go. Go well, brother. And you know what? I felt so energized and so blessed by that benediction. All of us fall into one of three categories: the energized, the neutralized, and the vandalized. I've spent some time lately among the neutralized and the vandalized. And it is just a word like that that can be so energizing in the middle of despair, in the middle of need. This week, wherever you find yourself on the continuum, energized, neutralized, vandalized, may you be energized by that benediction of heavenly grace, mercy, beauty, goodness, truth, and joy. Please stand for the prayers.